Hey everybody! Welcome to Let's Look at Divide by Sheep. Divide by Sheep, published by Tiny Build Games, who you may know from Speedrunners. If you're familiar with them, it probably is through Speedrunners, or maybe No Time to Explain, which came out a couple of years ago in full retail form. It is coming to Xbox One, I think, fairly soon. But this is made by a two-person team, as far as I'm aware, and it is... I'm gonna coin, if I may, a new kind of genre type here. It is an iOS puzzler, if you will. The same way, you know, when you think about a physics-based puzzle platformer, you're like, okay, you've got, you know, Braid and Limbo and, I guess, technically stuff like World of Goo and Vessel and stuff like that. This is an iOS puzzler. It's a minimalistic puzzle game, math-focused, very simplistic, presented in kind of a cartoony way. I'm basically trying to define the genre, I guess, right now as I speak. That being said, right off the cut, let me say that there are a lot of people who are not into these kinds of games, and there's a larger subset of people, or I guess it's not really a subset if it's larger, but there is a large group of people who are not into these games, particularly on the PC. They think, you know, oh, I use my PC for more maximal experiences, I keep stuff like this for, you know, when I'm on the commute to work or something like that on the bus. That's totally acceptable. I've been playing it on PC, I played about 45 minutes so far, which is more than enough to understand what's going on here, and I kind of like it. I can understand, if you watch it and you go, hey, this isn't the kind of thing that I'd really sit down and invest, you know, 4 hours with in the company of my own home when I have stuff like The Witcher 2 I could be playing instead, The Witcher 3 I could be playing instead. You can play The Witcher 2 if you want to as well, but it's kind of cool. I like it, and it's a nice little Sudoku puzzle, if you will, a nice little crossword puzzle, a little bit of step above a word search maybe. It's interesting. One thing you'll notice for sure, iOS-y menu design, to the point where sometimes with my mouse I'm like, I don't really know what to do. This is available for iOS as well. It's $5 on Steam, just came out yesterday, so Thursday probably. I have done the first 30 levels here. There are more worlds, as you can see, that you can get later in the game, so it actually is kind of a long release as far as puzzle games go anyway. This is 4 worlds, which probably represents maybe, I don't know, 3 to 4 hours of gameplay. Seems fairly reasonable to me. We might be able to run through all 30 levels here as I explain just what the heck is going on. There's no voice work or anything like that. There is a light story, you know, this tends to happen in games of this scope. Basically, you know, the Grim Reaper is here, and he's like, I don't have any friends. That's pretty shitty, so I've got an idea. What if I kidnapped a bunch of animals, like wolves and also sheep, that I could be friends with? It's basically just a thin conceit for you to actually play the game. I guess you are playing as Death here, but really this is a mechanics-focused game. It's definitely not focused on narrative or anything like that, by the way. You need the mouse pointer if you're going, ooh, why you got the mouse pointer up here? Alright, so this has a scoring system, or a level completion system, that you are going to be very familiar with if you have played any other iOS-style games. Please, I don't need the tutorial, but I will do so. If you look over here on the left side of the screen, we've got basically 3 objectives. Get 2 sheep to the raft. Done. Step 2, we have to do these in order, by the way. Get 4 sheep to the raft. Okay, so it's very easy. We'll just get 4 sheep to the raft by clicking and dragging. And then get 6 sheep to the raft. As you might expect, this is very simplistic. All we do is click and drag. But it does get much more mechanically complex as the game goes on. And it's not all cutesy. It also gets a little bit gory as well. It's got kind of like that... I'm trying to think of what it's... Like a little Adventure Time-y almost, where it's like mature cute or mature cartoony, if you know what I mean. Okay, so this one again is very simple. Get 4 over here, and then 2 over here, and then 4 over here. Well, by the way, we could, if we wanted to... there, it's teaching you the mechanic that, you know, if you go from 5 platforms to 4 platforms, then you are going to lose the sheep in the process, which is something that's very important. This is not like save all the sheep is not your objective. Your objective is often kill enough sheep to mathematically complete the objectives. That's why I get it when I say, like, the story's a little bit of a thin conceit. It's more of a mechanics-focused game. We will need to do some complex stuff as we get going, and it gets introduced fairly quickly. Like, I've played for an hour, they've introduced like 45 minutes, I guess. They've introduced 4 or 5 new mechanics that you'll see here as we get going. So we gotta get 2 sheep to the end. Very simple. It does ramp up fairly quickly. I will say that it's fairly easy to get at least 1 star. Now, if we wanna get 6 sheep on here, we could do it 2 different ways. We could pull 4 on here and it'll totally work, or we could just put 6 on at the same time. But the thing that you need to know about the raft is basically you're learning about the rule set of the game. The raft will only leave when you hit the number that you need or overshoot it, basically. So if I put, like, if we restart this level, let me see if I can do it. How many sheep do they want on first? They want 2 sheep on first. So here's a way to learn this rule set. If I put 4 sheep on, it'll leave. If I somehow put 1 sheep on, which I don't even know is mathematically possible here, it will not leave. So you basically just want to try to avoid overshooting, and if you can do that, you'll be fine. But let's just beat this level again. So yeah, it's kind of crafting the rule set here. Things will get a little trickier, but what I was going to say is that in 45 minutes, I beat 30 levels. That's like a minute and a half per level, basically, if I'm being a little bit generous. So it's not hard to beat the levels. Some of the levels are a little hard to get all of the objectives, but you only need to get one of the objectives in order to actually get the... To get completion, basically. So it depends on how much of a perfectionist you are. So, again, on this one, we gotta get 4, and then we gotta get 1, which is gonna be easy, and then we gotta get 5. And this one, I guess, is teaching you that you can put them on in, you know, separate packs as long as you're under the weight limit for that raft, basically. These ones are pretty easy. We might actually skip ahead a few levels, but they are teaching us some new stuff now. So this one is teaching us, basically, I guess every 5 levels, maybe they introduce a new mechanic. This one is teaching us, you know, if you put sheep on an area that's already filled, it's gonna result in the overflow falling off, which is actually really important. Far from saving all the sheep, your goal in Divide by Sheep is most of the time to actually kill the exact right number of sheep in order to make it possible for you to complete the level. So if we look at this, 3, 4, 2, that is 9 sheep total we want to put on the raft. Rafts, I guess I should say. We got 5 here, 5 here, 6 here, 1 here. So that's 17. So we actually have to kill 8 sheep in order to make this work. The other thing that's worth noting, so we got to figure out how to kill each sheep, but we can put that kind of in the back of our mind for now, is that in a way this is almost like a Sokoban game, you know, like a block pushing game. Kind of like Sokoban, the chemical one that I played a couple years ago, or the follow-up from the same dude, You Must Build a Snowman. It's just a little bit of a aesthetically... What am I trying? Aesthetically obscuring block pushing game. Like, it doesn't look like a block pushing game, but when you get down to the mechanics of it, you're like, actually, this is a block pushing game with a cool aesthetic going on with it. So, one of the things that's very important is kind of just like looking at, okay, we need 3. Well, there's this 3 block right here. That is a perfect way to, like, almost as if you had too much Play-Doh and you were pushing it through a mold of a star or something like that. No matter how much Play-Doh you push through it, it's gonna come out in that star shape. Similarly, no matter how many sheep we put here, this is gonna come out as 3 sheep. So we can just take 5 and then push them through that 3 mold, and basically we end up with 3 there. Now this time we need 4, so, you know, no matter what, they're gonna have to become 3 right before the end. So we can make them 4 very easily here. We can do exactly the same thing here, you know, we've got 6 sheep. We can put them through what I'll call a 2 mold here, and there you go. It's very easy to get them through to the end. So that's kind of like one of the central gimmicks of the game. Are they introducing something new already? Oh, they introduced electric fences. All right, that's a pretty thin mechanic, but hopefully now you're taking me at face value when I said, like, yo, check it out. There's, like, a lot of mechanics or new gimmicks that get introduced as you go here. The first few levels are super, super easy, but as you get going further and further, it actually gets more complex. I got a lot of two stars, and I think at least 1-star level still here in the first world. But you do start to think in it, like, you think within the language of the game the more you play, which is a really cool thing, I think, and I never really found myself being like, I have absolutely no idea where to start. In that way, I think it's very accessible. Alright, so we got 6 first. This one has 8. Well, the electric fence, to teach you about the mechanic, you just can't jump through it. It doesn't do anything. It blocks the ability to send them there. So we have 6, 3, 4. That is 13. This is 8. This is 13. So we've got to kill 3 sheep. If we do this, we will kill 7. That's too much, I think. I wonder how I've done on this level in the past. I hope it's 3 stars. But if we pull these guys back here, this will kill 1. This, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's 6. This will kill 2, so I think this is actually perfect. And then we can bring 6 back this way. But we do have a problem now in that we need to, keep 3 alive. Okay, so we can do it like this, I think, and bring 4 back this way. The reason this one's tricky is because we could have obviously put 4 on the raft and then 3, but that's not the way we need to do it in order for our objective. So we've got to either send that raft away and then put 4 on, or we've got to do it the right way. You know, put 3 on and then put 4 on, and that works fine. I remember this one giving me a little bit of trouble the first time I did it, but now I've got it down, hopefully, a little bit here. Maybe we'll skip through a couple of levels here just so I'm not wasting your time. Probably pause is what we want to do here. Again, the iOS menus, it's a bit of a sore spot for me. It's not a huge problem. Let's move ahead to, like, level 12, let's say. It's not a huge problem, but it can be a little annoying, and I don't think that necessarily, like, people I think are way too quick to judge iOS games that come out on Steam or PC at the same time, or even later. They go, oh, it's too expensive. Honestly, I think $5 is a very realistic price point for a game like this, coming from iOS, where it's probably $1 to $3. It's just a different market, and, you know, it would be cool if it was $3, but I'm not gonna be a dick, basically, over $2, especially when Steam sales come around all the time. But also, there's so many, like, iOS games I play. Like, I played Card Dungeon, and that game was so unoptimized for PC. It was still kind of interesting, but everything was, if I may use my mouse pointer here, everything was confined, basically, especially on the UI, to, like, this area of the screen with a bunch of black bars on the side. This actually looks good. Blown up here, this game itself. Like, it looks like they definitely did QA for it. Not that, you know, Card Hunter didn't, but it looks fine on PC. I don't like the menus, but that's a UI UX thing that is, you know, me because I'm old, maybe to some extent. Anyway, alright, so we're getting a little bit more complex here. We gotta put 5 on the raft. So we know that we're only going to be able to put 4 on the raft this way. Let's do a little bit of math here. It's an arithmetic game as well, you know, that's at least a chunk of it. 5, 4, 3, so that is 12, and we've got 6, 9, 13, so we got to kill 1. The easiest way that I can think of to do that is like this. But now we have, well, let's do the math. Now we have 12, and we want to put 12 on there, which is fine. But how in the heck are we going to move these 6? 6 is too big for us to move, so we want to restart it here. One big thing I really wish the game had, and maybe I'm missing it, but considering there's only like 3 buttons here, I don't think I am. It would be really nice if there was an undo move button. Instead, sometimes you'll puzzle it out, and maybe you do this. You go, oh, like, I want to do this, and then that, and oh, I messed up. There's no undo move. You have to restart the whole level. That, I think, is a major oversight that actually does detract from the game a little bit. Okay. So we got to get 5 on the raft. What if we did it like this? Again, this is where I think it's kind of a little bit of like a block-pushing game. So we'll put 3 on the raft. And then we'll rotate around and we'll put 2 on the raft. That'll get that sent away, and then we can put 4 on the raft. Then we gotta send 3 on the raft, so we'll put 4 over here, push them through the 3 mold, and then just bring them back. And that'll get that done. There's something very satisfying about it as well. Ah, this is what I was looking for. So these are wolves. These add a really interesting dynamic to the game in that they give you kind of conflicting objectives, in a way. So let's go over our mission first here. We gotta get 3 sheep on the raft, then 1 wolf, then 2 sheep. What do we need to learn about wolves? If a wolf occupies the same space as a sheep, it will eat it, 100%. But every wolf can only eat 1 sheep, and then it gets like fat and lazy, and it can't move anymore. So for example, if I move 2 wolves over here, they will eat 2 sheep, 2 sheep will still be alive, and these 2 wolves will never be able to move again. So we can use these almost as like stones, basically. We can use them to eliminate sheep, that's for sure, but we can also use them to block space if we want to create, like, a 3 mold, for example, which might be a good idea on a mission like this, or maybe we could even use them to create a 2 mold. Like, if I come back this way, I think if we move these sheep over here, there you go. We've taken those wolves out of the equation, and we've basically created a 2 mold, which is very useful because we'll be able to push. Well, we want to get 2 sheep on eventually, so we created a 2 mold, and maybe we can create a 1 mold, like here. And now, well, yeah, it's not really a 1 mold, that's still a 2 mold, but anyway, you get the idea. Wolves also, you know, you want to put them on the raft, but remember, once they're full, they can't move. So let's start here. We want to get 3 sheep on first. How many wolves do we need in the end? Just 1? So let's eliminate as many wolves as we can here. And then we'll put 3 sheep on the easy way, so that's at least our completion of the level done. Now we've got to put 1 wolf on. So we need like a spot of 3 sheep, basically. Which I don't know is even possible for me to create right now. If I do this, all the wolves will go down. If I do this, 2 wolves will go, and it'll create a 2 mold, but I can't really do too much with a 2 mold here. Wait. Okay, eliminate 1. No, it's still going to be a 2 mold either way, so I've fudged this one up a little bit. Like, we could put 2 wolves on, we could still get 2 stars here by fucking up that middle objective and then just getting this one done here. Alright, so let's restart it here. Keep in mind, first off, I'm bad at puzzle games. Secondly, I'm kind of deliberately throwing a little bit or playing haphazardly, you could say. So if you see the solution, you feel free to shout out in the comments below, but every time I cover a puzzle game, people are like, oh, I can't believe Northern Lion is a functional adult in society. He can't even figure out the sheep and wolf puzzle on the first try. Meanwhile, me, internet genius, has figured it out just on my sight read. That's very impressive. I'm very happy for you. At the same time, recognize that backseat driving is always easier than regular driving because you never make any mistakes. And especially, you don't have people watching you backseat drive at the same time. But you know what's really annoying? Backseat driving. Get out of my dreams and also get out of my car. you're not welcome here. I've passed my tests, and I drive safely. I take it as a privilege and a responsibility, not as a lark. Anyway, here we go. Three sheep. How do we want to do this? We want to create, like, a two-mold. But we don't want to do it the same way we've been doing it. My brain has frozen up here. I got out of Divide by Sheep mode and into my soapbox. Let's start. I mean, like, I like our first plan seemed to work out relatively well. This will create a... I wish I could just get, like, one to you. But I don't want, like, all of our wolves to be out of the system. We need to keep one wolf alive. The easiest way to keep one wolf alive is that right there. But then the problem is, how do we get three sheep to the exit here? We could easily get two, like this, but how the heck are we gonna divide by one, basically? Because you might be thinking, oh, you got a one mold up here, but I don't really have a one mold up here. I mean, I do now, but now I don't have any wolves. All the wolves have been consumed. So that's not really gonna provide us with much benefit at all there. So we gotta figure out how to get three sheep to the end. We might have to go with just getting two stars here because I'm bad. But we'll give this one more shot before we move on to, like, a little bit of a later level to show off some of the other new mechanics as well. It's really remarkable to me. I think it's one of the major strengths of the game, how much new stuff they introduce within the scope of the first 30 levels, which is the first world. Like, it gets much more difficult. It's not like the first world is exclusively tutorials, unless the rest of the game gets unfathomably hard. Okay, so we got three sheep. Gotta get three sheep to the end. The super easy way, it looks like, to do this was the same way we did it before, but I don't know if this is a good first move. This creates a weird situation for us. Okay, so we gotta get one wolf to the end. Ideally, we would thus, somehow remove three sheep to keep one wolf around. But I don't know how we remove three sheep because we don't have a three mold. It's like we need a three mold in advance, but we need the three mold to create the three mold. There's no three mold! Unless, wait a minute. Move these over here. That is a three mold. Okay. We only need five sheep, and presently we have nine. So we need to kill four sheep. Well, need is maybe a strong word, but you get the idea. What if we move you over here? That gives us three sheep. And then we need to kill two sheep. How does one kill two sheep? One would kill two sheep this way. This will kill one. This will kill one. And we need to kill one more? I don't know what I've done. Okay, well, this three, this will kill two. I don't want to kill two. I only want to kill one. What if I put you here? Okay, this will do it. This, we got five now, but then we can't get them back. I'm an idiot. Okay, but let's do it this way. Oh, no, wait. We gotta use the wolves. Okay, I think I actually solved it, weirdly enough. Three on there. We don't want to do this on here. We want to do it on, like, the five piece. But then all the wolves are going to be dead. There's going to be no sheep left for me. Whatever, we got two objectives accomplished. Cool. See? I'm an idiot, but we can click that button to go on to the next level. Let's take a look at maybe level... Let's look at a level I three-starred. We'll go to level 20 here. Okay, so this is where things get interesting. We introduced two new mechanics here that we have not seen before. One of which is the laser fence. One of which is the bounce pad, is what I'm going to call it. The spring. Let's talk about the spring first. Very simple. Again, this is where arithmetic comes in. The spring, if it points in two directions, splits the group of sheep that land on it evenly. So, let's do a little math puzzle. If four sheep land on the spring, where do they go? If you answered two go to here and two go to here, you are correct. If three land on the spring, what happens? I believe that two go back to the origin and one goes to the other spot. Let's check. Clearly, I was incorrect. Let's try it again. Okay, maybe it's 50-50. If two bounce on it, one goes, obviously. I'm not sure. Maybe it's, again, 50-50 because it seems like they're splitting differently. But anyway, I don't think it has to do with when the arrows light up. So, those bounce pads are important. They're a little finicky, I'll admit. Let's put five on here first just to make it super easy. Okay, now we got four. We gotta land four sheep. The sheep do not have to be alive, weirdly enough. But first, I guess we'll just put four on here the easy way, because this will split them up, and we don't have to literally split them up, and you'll know what I mean in a second here. We could also conceptualize four sheep as eight halves of sheep. When you go through the laser, as you might expect, The sheep, I guess is one word, are split in half and the game becomes quite gory and sad. However, you know, this is four sheep parts right here. When they land, they're kind of reconstructed. You know, the game is basically like, oh, I didn't mean to do that. That's where an undo button would be very helpful for me. But the game's kind of like good enough. You know, you did it. So let's do this again because I am an idiot. If we bounce five over here. So this is where it gets interesting because you kind of have to start thinking of like, not only is there empty space, full space, now there's like half full space. You can't stack up two half parts in one space, but they're each only worth a half, which mathematically can be worthwhile for you. So again, we want to just very quickly put four over here, and then hopefully you'll understand a little bit more of what I'm saying once we do this. Okay, so technically, how many sheep are over here? Two. This is correct. How many sheep are over here? Two. This is correct. Let's bounce two more over there. Now we got three, and we have one half plus one half, which is one over here. So we can get these going over here. If you thought it was all going to be cutesy, you were incorrect, good sir. This escalated very quickly. And of course, all the mechanics, they interact with one another as you go throughout the game here. We got to get two over here, so why don't we split you guys up? And you bounce two back at me, thank you. So we can put three over here. Now we got to find some way to get five over here. And admittedly, I'm terrible at interacting with these bounce pads. Might as well put three over here first, and then four. And we want to make sure there's only two on this next one. That's not really the way I would have liked to have done it. Send one back. I sure got the shit to make your booty go smack. There we go. And now we've got to get two over this way, which should be very, very easy. So you're learning, hopefully, here as we go. I think that's pretty much all I need to say about Divide by Sheep. I mean, it's a little bit of a short video, but at the same time, this represents, you know, like another third of the amount of time I've spent with it in total. We can take a quick look here at the later levels. It gets pretty complicated here. This one is full wolves. We got to get six wolves to the end, and we only have one sheep with which to augment it. So it's a little touch and go, and let's try like a quick sight read here. We know that this is a three mold, so we can pretty easily just put six wolves on it. How the heck are we going to get two? Well, it seems like this is a fairly easy way to get that done. Am I just going to do it here? What is this? This is a five mold, so we got to send them through like a four mold or something first. Five, three. We need seven. So how many do we have? Five, six, eight. We got to kill one. There's a really easy way to do that, but we're going to kill two right here no matter where we go, I think. Yeah, there's nothing we can do about that, so we should have set this up in a different way, but yeah, that's only going to give us six, which we can't do, but I'm still pretty pleased with the fact that we got two stars there. Anyway, this is Divide by Sheep. Obviously, it's the kind of thing that's not going to be for everybody. It's a niche title, and it occupies kind of an unenviable space on Steam, which is, you know, much maligned iOS and Steam concurrent release, or even worse for a lot of people, iOS to Steam. I don't share that sentiment. I'll judge the game on its merits, not its platform of choice, or whatever originally or it was designed for. And it works fine. I like it. It's not necessarily something I'd recommend as an absolute 100% must-buy, but if you find it interesting, $5 can get you several hours of math puzzly goodness on Steam if you're interested. I'm not sure how much it is on iOS, because I'm not playing it on iOS. And certainly if this came down in price a couple bucks in a Steam sale, it's something that's a little bit more of an impulse purchase, I imagine, for a lot of people. If you're the kind of person who likes to, spend maybe like a little Saturday morning with coffee and a puzzle game, you could do a lot worse than this. I've found it tickling the right parts of my brain. Gives me a good ability to remember, like, hey, remember when you used to use arithmetic like every day in school? See how much of that you remember. Graphically fine, music, it gets a little grating hearing exactly the same song for an hour, over and over and over. It's not the best puzzle game I've ever played, but it is a lot of fun. Reminds me a little bit of like, Girls Like Robots. I played that like a year ago, maybe even a little bit more than a year ago. It was pretty cool. Again, not for everybody, but a mild thumbs up for sure. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed the episode. There will be a link to pick up Divide by Sheep on Steam if you are interested. That will be in the video description below. And of course, if you enjoyed the episode, click the like button. It helps out a lot. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. For now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.